everybody, I'm Mike Hatrop. I'm an AMGA ski guide and Black Diamond ambassador, and I'm really excited to share with you one of the products that I think is a true breakthrough in the snow safety world. It's the Peeps Pro IPS Avalanche Transceiver. It's loaded with features, but there's three in particular that I'd like to focus on. First, it's interference protection system. Second is dual antenna signal processing. And the last one, it's Bluetooth compatible with the Peeps app. The first feature I want to talk about is IPS, which stands for Interference Protection System. And the interference that we're concerned about is electromagnetic interference. And that can come from anything electronic or metallic. And the reason this is important is because 20 years ago, nobody talked about this because we weren't carrying around all these electronic items that we have today. But now, think about some of the most common things that come along on a ski tour. And some of those, your phone is obviously one of those. And by the way, putting it in airplane mode does not help, okay? A smartwatch, Garmin inReach, GoPro, foil-wrapped candy bars, or goo wrappers, even some of your avalanche protection equipment like an aluminum probe or aluminum shovel will cause interference. So hopefully you're familiar with the 20/50 rule. And the 20/50 rule is you need 20 centimeters of separation between your beacon and anything that could cause interference. And when you're searching, you need 50 centimeters of separation between your beacon and anything that could cause interference. So first I want to talk about send mode. Hopefully you start your ski tours by saying, hey, everybody put their hand on their beacon and their cell phone and make sure you've got separation. The problem is that after you're touring a little bit and the phone comes out to either navigate or maybe take a picture, and then it goes back in your jacket pocket because you're not paying attention, and now it's right on top of your beacon. Or let's say you get a goo shot or something, squeeze that out, throw the wrapper in your pocket. You don't think twice about it. Now that's right on top of your beacon. So what's cool about this beacon and makes it absolutely unique is that if you have some form of interference right on top of the beacon will sense that interference and it will boost the signal back up to where it should be. Because what interference does is it suppresses the signal of the beacon. So that means the person searching for you, if you do get buried, needs to be closer to you to pick up a signal. So what this beacon does, it senses that interference and it boosts the signal back up to where it should be. And that's groundbreaking in the industry. The second form of interference I want to talk about is when you're in search mode. So if I'm searching for somebody, I need to have 50 centimeters between my beacon and anything that could cause interference. What this beacon does is it will let you know if you have interference. So when you first flip open the antenna, it will show 80 meters of search strip. So that's the recommended search strip width. If it detects interference, it will ratchet that down in 20 meter segments. So if there's a little bit of interference, it will say, hey, go down to a 60 meter search strip width. If there's a little bit more, say go down to 40 or all the way down to 20. If you see that, the first thing you should do is say, hey, what's causing that interference, and try and figure it out and get rid of it. So maybe you have a smartwatch on, or maybe you have a heated glove that's surrounding your beacon. Okay, whatever it is, get rid of that. And if the interference doesn't go away, then it's maybe due to some outside source. Okay, if you're at the bottom of if you're at a ski area and there's an avalanche, there's all kinds of interference. Okay, so then maybe you're gonna have to search with that shorter search strip width. So, but at any rate, this will give you an indication of where you should be. So it's super helpful that way. The next really unique feature about the Pro IPS is DASP, and that's dual antenna signal processing. Before I get into that, I wanna talk a bit about antennas. All advanced modern beacons have three antennas. There's an X, a Y, and a Z. And Z is only used when you get into the fine search. This particular beacon, the X flips out on this swing arm. That does a couple things. One, it gets the antenna away from the internal workings of the beacon, which actually cause a little bit of interference. So, and that's one of the things that gives us such a long range. The other thing it does is it makes it super obvious when you're in search mode and when you're in send mode. So I know all of us have had friends that we've introduced to the backcountry, and you show them how to use a beacon, and they're like, is this thing on search or send? There's no guessing with this. It's very clear, not only to them, but to you as an observer, if they're in search or send mode. So how these beacons work in search mode is that signal processing goes back and forth from the X to the Y antenna. And that's how you get the directional arrow. This is the only beacon in the world that processes both antenna simultaneously. So think about it this way. If you walk outside and there's a noise and you're trying to figure out where it comes from and you're covering one ear and then the next, okay, you're not going to be as fast or accurate in detecting where that noise comes from as if you'd had both ears working simultaneously. And so that's what this does. It gives you a more accurate, more stable signal that takes you more directly to the beacon. The third really cool feature about this beacon is it's Bluetooth compatible. So there's a Peeps app that you can download on your phone, and from there you can register your beacon, you can do a full diagnostic, which we recommend you doing once a year, and it will go through all the different functions of the beacon and make sure they're working properly. And if you're a guide service, you can get a printout of a PDF with a date stamp that you can use for future reference. You also get regular firmware updates. You don't need to send the beacon in for that. And there's a ton of different training scenarios that you can go through. And I think one of the coolest things about the app is it allows you to have your own beacon park. So if you have three other Peeps or Black Diamond beacons, you can bury those beacons once, and each of those shows up on your phone app. And through your phone, you can turn off the beacon, turn on the beacon, so you can have single burial, multiple burial, turn these two on, turn those two on, and you can switch between the X antenna turning on or the Y antenna turning on, and each of those will give you a different training scenario. So you can optimize your time training instead of burying and digging up beacons all day. Last, it allows you to take all the complicated features of the beacon and take those off the beacon and put them on the phone. So all the advanced features you can control from the phone, which makes your beacon really clean and simple and easy to use. As I mentioned at the outset, there are a ton of other features with this beacon. First one is an industry-leading 80 meter search strip width. And search strip matters because 45% of all ski tours only have two people. And if you're a single searcher, range matters. Second, it's got a group check, and people think group check is just a simple way to check everybody's beacon at the trailhead to make sure they're all on. But what group check does is it also checks the pulse, period, and frequency to make sure they're within the standard. Next, it's got a mark function. It's got a scan function, which gives you a visual map and tells you how many people are within 5, 20, and 90 meters. And the advanced scan also gives you a directional arrow for each of those. It also has analog function, so for those complicated scenarios, you can switch to analog if you like. And as you can see, the beacon is super feature rich. And it's the most advanced beacon on the market, but one thing that's important to note is that it's not just for professionals. It's easy to use, whether you're a guide, whether you're a weekend warrior, and it's the safest beacon on the market.